that Muslims have been able to establish their possessory title. So as far as faith is concerned, the Supreme Court says that we accept and recognize the fact that the Hindus, their faith is legally acceptable. But the Supreme Court says we're not going to enter into that territory. Whether that was right, wrong, we're not going to enter that. There is faith and there is enough and more legal evidence to show that that faith was being executed. And how was that faith being executed? It was being executed, it was being shown by the fact that there was worshipping of the God. There was worshipping, there was puja, aarti, which was taking place within this territory. But now the Supreme Court says it cannot be said that Muslims have been able to establish the possessory title, which means that as far as the fundamental question of ownership of this land is concerned, the Muslims do not have the right. They have not been able to establish their possessory title. That's the argument which is being made. That's the order which is being passed. Anusha, is that the right reading when the Chief Justice says it cannot be said that Muslims have been able to establish their possessory title?
See, Bhupendra, if you read it with what Supreme Court was earlier saying, Supreme Court is saying that the Muslims don't have a right to adverse possession, which means straight away you don't have a right to the place just because you were holding the place. Then the Supreme Court goes on to say that the Hindus have been praying at that site for over 100 years now. The Garbh Grah was always the place where the Hindus were worshipping. Then the court goes on to say that you also cannot say that the Muslims completely abandoned that place. So the court is making a nuanced argument here. The court is saying Muslims do not have an adverse possession, which means that Hindus did not have a right. Adverse possession means an exclusive right. Nobody else is there. Hindus were present there, which means there is no adverse possession. The court is hinting that though the Muslims, they have not been able to establish a possessory title, they did not abandon the property. At the same time, it was the Hindus that kept on worshipping on that land. So Hindus and Muslims both were present. Possession title not established, adverse possession not established. We're waiting of what the conclusion is that the Supreme Court is reading. The court right now is hinting at the possibility that because there is no adverse possession, no exclusive possession you have been able to establish, your right cannot be exclusive in nature and cannot be absolute.
The important point to underline here is the court. The court is saying that this land does not belong to the Muslims. The land on which the Babri stood, the land on which the Hindus believe there's a Ram temple which existed earlier, that's not an argument which is being accepted by the court. The court says that there was a structure which existed. Whether it was Ram temple, Shaivite temple is something that we'd still have to wait and watch out for. But the court is now giving its decision very, very clearly that the Muslim side has not been able to establish exclusive rights, exclusive possession of this disputed right. The Hindus continue to worship on Ram Chabutra. The Hindus continue to worship from the railings on the Ram Chabutra, and there is enough and more evidence, according to the Chief Justice, to show that Hindus, like Muslims, were displaying their right to worship. So their faith was being clearly shown. Mosque was not completely Islamic in nature. Inner courtyard has been contentious, says the Supreme Court. And now that's it. That's the next important part of this entire argument, of this entire judgment. When the Supreme Court says that mosque was not completely Islamic in nature. So 2 points to watch out for. Point number one, the Muslim side does not control the land. It does not own the land, is being stated very, very clearly by the Supreme Court. The Sunni Waqf Board may have had a good legal case, so their suit was entertained by the Supreme Court, but the Supreme Court says that they've not been able to prove their suit. They've not been able to prove their case that this land belongs just to the Muslims. Suits of Sunni Waqf Board, Ramlala Virajman, will be decreed and relief be molded. So just like we were saying that for Nirmoya Khada, big setback, Shia Waqf Board nowhere in the game. The Sunni Waqf Board for the longest time since 1950s had argued that this land belonged to them, and therefore they were the real title holders, the real owners, controllers of that land deed. The Supreme Court is making it very, very clear. There was no namaz which was offered after 1949. So if there was no namaz which was being offered post 1949, then the Sunni Waqf Board's contention that this land belonged to them does not hold. Hindus have exclusive possession of the outer courtyard. Suits of Sunni Waqf Board, Ramlala Virajman, being decreed. That's the fundamental argument which is being made. Anand, setback for Sunni Waqf Board, Shia Waqf Board, yes, removed. Nirmoya Khada removed. Where are we headed to now, Anand?
Well, it looks like the arguments which have been placed in such a way that